intolerant towards people with different opinions and choices? Let's start with you, Swara, since you have the mic.
I think that I would sadly have to agree. I think that there is a pretty genuine problem of tolerance in our society, and it's only growing. And I think it's very strange because India is and has always been a multicultural, multilingual, multi-ethnic, multiracial, I mean, how many ever multis you can think of, all that, India has always been that. That has been the birth and genesis of the civilization, not from now, from, you know, the Indus Valley times onwards. So it's strange that as a society we are increasingly, while our phones are getting smarter and our shopping malls are getting, you know, fancier and our roads are getting, well, not wider, but whatever, our cars are getting more in number, but as a people we are becoming more and more intolerant of very simply being able to live with difference in our society. It could be difference of culinary habits, as this meat ban controversy is showing us. It could be difference of thought, worldview, sexuality, I mean anything. So I think that it's a sad truth about us.
Right. Bora said, first of all, good afternoon, everybody, and Nikhil, congratulations. Your movie looks fantastic. Congratulations. And I hope it does really well. And that's 10% of the that we decided. Now, we have a deal, 10% of what he makes for me coming down. But anyways, so I agree with half in politics. I don't give nothing. But no, I agree with what Swara said. As a society, when you look back at India, it is the most diverse society in the world. I think the only other country that comes close to in being as diverse as India is the United States of America. And like the United States of America, India is mostly a country of immigrants. Now, it's a country that over centuries, with the culture that we have, has been so diverse, so tolerant, so different. Unfortunately, the same diverse culture is being misrepresented to bring about these so-called bans, to bring about hate, to bring about violence, to bring about all sorts of, and violence is not just physical, even mental violence. I just read this morning on the flight, the Shiv Sena said now that rickshawalas have to speak Marathi or they won't be allowed. I mean, the fact is, you know, you're moving towards, instead of becoming a globalized country, instead of becoming a globalized city, which Mumbai is, but I'm talking on a macro level on India, you started to become more and more intolerant of other people. And I don't think India as a society, as a race, we are intolerant. I think it's the few who are intolerant, but they get space in media, and the majority of us who are tolerant do not raise our voice against it. And I don't want to, it's not about me, but you know, when this officer called Doble was moral policing and arresting women, the amount of calls I got from Mumbai police not to take action against him and the amount of pressure that is built up, I don't understand. And the liberal voices in Mumbai, the liberal voices in India, refuse to speak up. And then comes the problem. The problem is not the society just becoming intolerant, it's the majority who are liberal not speaking up against what is going on, the intolerance. I think therein is the problem. And that sadly is what started happening in Germany. Nobody spoke up when they went for the socialists, nobody spoke up when they went for the Jews, nobody spoke up when they went for the handicapped, nobody spoke up when they went for the gays, and ultimately nobody was there to speak up and they came after me. Unfortunately, the majority is not speaking up. Therein is the problem.
Right. We need our attention.
Hi, good afternoon everyone. I'm Professor Amisha Dawda, associated with Xavier's College, with opinion at times. You know, people are not going to support you. That is one of the reasons, like, you want to just keep quiet and like you suppress your thoughts. So this can be a very critical, I mean, there can be a lot of critical factors in this case. I have a suggestion to this. There can be a portal online and where you can invite a lot of ideas through crowdsourcing techniques. And that ideas can be a win-win situation, I think, so that can really help out the society. Thank you so much.
Well, that's a great suggestion. We all mostly just talk about
the LGBT rights. In India, what I see is, like, I mean, I think India is so diverse, as we've been talking, that, like, we actually still live in the 16th and the 21st century at the same time, when you see the villages or the smaller cities and the metros. When we talk about tolerance in the metros, we perceive that there's a lot of tolerance, but in fact, it's not. But when you go to a smaller town, you think they're intolerant, but actually there's much more tolerance. Yeah. So in terms of LGBT community as such, okay, 377 was read down. Section 377, which kind of criminalizes homosexuality. Yeah. after that, from 2009 to 2013, there has been a lot of visibility of younger people coming out and being who they are and claiming for their own space in terms of, I'm an LGBT person, I'm gay, I'm lesbian, I'm transgender. And that's really encouraging. But what was a dampener was your 2013 Supreme Court verdict, which kind of reversed everything back. And now, in fact, we see actually a lot more intolerance coming out, because what happened is, like, now you have this bunch of younger people who have come out, you know, and they've said so, that now for them to be branded as a criminal again, and their parents are now questioning, you know. Parents are questioning, okay, you have come out, so what is your status now? I mean, are you a criminal? Who are you going to marry? There's absolutely no status for you anymore. So that kind of a pressure by parents, I think it's immense at this point of time. And that also is supported by a larger kind of, I would say, the government, to the kind of decisions the government is taking across board. And just a small diversion is basically also government cut off all the funding for HIV/AIDS intervention. Now, what also, because of that, during this time, actually, we had started a lot of community-based organizations. We started around 150 community-based organizations to close down. So where will the LGBT people go to find any support? So that's actually the point now in terms of the way things are moving.
Well, Sridhar, you mentioned the role of does anyone want to add to that?
I think I'll take this chance to sort of speak out the voice of the youth, and while everyone's added such nice pointers to it, I think one major problem which everybody overlooks is the fact that everyone forms their opinions and everyone is given their opinions in school.
Right.
Now, we went to literally almost every school in Delhi, and you name it, we must have approached them. And one point which he made was very right. You would think that Delhi would be liberal about this, the main cities would be.
Yeah.
But the support we got was from the satellite cities. And even a city like Gurgaon, which is supposed to be this corporate hub and it's supposed to have these smart thinking individuals, principals jumped out of their seat when we said we want to make a film about homosexuality, which deals with sexuality in schools. I've received comments from parents saying, mere bete ko, uski koi girlfriend nahi hai, mere ko uski sexuality, usko sexuality wagera ke bare mein bhi kuch malum nahi hai. How can you talk to him about homosexuality? This is a class 12 student who's sitting in my audition room with his girlfriend. You know, and that is the big disconnect. The parents, the principals think that kids are dumb. They don't know what's happening, but hey, we have the internet now. You know, 12, 13-year-old people are coming out with this. They are discovering their sexuality, and there's no one that they can go and speak to or address this to. So before we reach the higher authorities, before we reach people who are out there, I think it's the
grassroots
schools and the grassroots that need a major overhaul. All these teachers, my English teacher told me that making a film on homosexuality is illegal.
Wow.
And she hasn't spoken to me since then because I came out and said this openly, and she's angry with me. I've never taken her name.
Yeah.
It's complete guilt conscious. I've never taken her name. But she's completely anti me, completely against this, because I came out and said what you're saying is wrong, and I had a different opinion from her.
And
nobody's encouraged to have an opinion.
And well, these people kind of have a great impact on students and on people.
You
and
know,
parents.
Someone hit upon this great idea in India that if you don't like something, just say it's illegal. So it's like, whatever you don't like, it's illegal. So I just wanted, before we move on to the next thing, I think that, I mean, it's a beautifully made film. Whoever is here who hasn't seen it, it's a really nicely, sensitively done film, very well performed by all the various actors who are here. I'm saying that because I'm an actor. I just want to say, because you talked about parents, and it's something that the film sort of touches upon as well. I think and you said, wo bichare parents jinke bacche out ho gaye aur uske baad criminalize ho gaye agle saal. So it's kind of, it's a tough thing for any family, especially when there is cross-generational sort of values involved, you know. I think that our parents and their parents cannot help that they were born in a time where, you know, we also have access to a lot more information and a lot more freedom of thought that perhaps that generation did not. And so in some sense, their fears are quite natural. And I think that perhaps as youngsters and as people who are fairly confident and, you know, very sassy and clever with all our comments and whatever, perhaps we can help our parents by actually, you know, by taking the first step of being honest and being, you know, being out there about who we are. And again, which is something your film does very nicely. And challenge them to rise to the occasion. Because I have found in my experience and in the experience of all my friends, parents always rise to whatever you bring them to, mostly. I mean, it's just, they can't help it. They're parents. So they may be scared, they may fight, they may get upset. But eventually, they somehow
they do come around.
Their love for you trumps everything at the end of the day.
On that note, can I just add, so the basic story of this film, where it's inspired from, is actually from this family. I was visiting my aunt in Germany, and over lunch.
Bonding and relationship, so that like, see, they understand you. It's just something new. There's something different, you know? So it's like saying that, like, okay, I want to have this completely different kind of hairstyle, and the parents don't know what the hell is happening with them, you know? So it takes time to for that mother to just get used to this different hairstyle. In the same way, I think it's really, if you really have a conversation, I think parents do really understand. But you know what? Okay, let me say this, like, I'm a gay man, I've been out for like last 25 years, but my mother, I've been having this conversation for the last 20 years with my mother, but believe me, she's okay with me, she's okay with my partner, everything. But within that, because of the Indian tradition and culture, the word homosexuality, the whole idea, does not really yet be okay.
Friend. So, special friend. So, you know, it's I don't know, maybe.
Oh, your dad has graduated to special friend? My dad is like that boy you roam with.
That boy.
That boy.
Yeah. Usually you come up with problems, what is the point? You have to come up with a solution. That is, like, again, very important.
Yeah, so before coming up with a solution, there's just one thing, and I'm going to take from where you left it. Indian culture, and since I study mythology, does accept homosexuality, and there's no two ways about it. There are several examples I can give you in Indian culture, in Indian scriptures, where homosexuality is not just accepted, it's celebrated. So anybody who says that Indian culture does not accept homosexuality or this is an alien concept is talking rubbish, because unhone Indian culture padhai nahi. Second cheese, the problem with our parents is, and this is a slightly macro problem, the problem with the generation is, when the British came into India, we were so embarrassed of our culture. What we today talk about being Indian culture is actually the Western British Victorian culture that is being imposed upon us and taken away our Indian culture. And today when we see the US or you see Europe opening up, that is actually the Indian culture. So there's been a difference. Out of our own embarrassment, out of our own not reading enough of our culture, we today think that their culture is about accepting, for example, homosexuality, and our culture is about not accepting homosexuality. Added to that, you have thugs like Ramdev who come up with medicines that can cure homosexuality, and then the government supports people like that. So we have this problem. It's a problem that is, what came first, the chicken or the egg?